So this is a day two class. In day two class, we are about to start free body diagram. Free body diagram of loaded bar. So suppose I am giving you any bar here, and I am considering that this bar is loaded this side with 10 kilonewton and this side with 9 kilonewton. And we can consider like in between also bar is being loaded. So imagine like here also bar is being loaded in this direction with 3 kilonewton, and here also bar is being loaded in this direction with 2 kilonewton. Let's give name for this. Suppose this is A, this is B, the total bar. And this small section in between is CD. So we have to find out in which bar you will be having compressive effect, in which bar, I mean which portion you will be having tensile effect. What does it mean? See, whenever you have any bar and you are applying any load, for example 20 kilonewton both side. So because of the loading, there will be change in length. So you can see the arrow is outward, so it means there will be tensile effect. So this loading is known as tensile loading, and because of tensile loading, length will increase. So tensile effect is coming here. So length is increasing, so change in length divided by original length, if you will do, you will be finding out the strain here. So main logic is how to find out change in length. So in last class, I gave you trick. The trick was the English word play, P-L-A-Y. So this play is the change in length. How to consider this trick? PL. P means applied load, L means original length. AY means divide by A means cross section area. Y means Young's modulus, symbol is E. So play. This gives you change in length directly. So this is very good, useful formula. So our job is to find out the total change in length of this bar under this loading condition. So for that we should know which portion of the bar is tensile, and I mean experiencing tensile loading, and which portion is experiencing compressive loading. So how to deal with that? It is very easy. For that we have to draw free body diagram of every individual portion. So let's consider AC first. So if I'm drawing AC first, then left side I have 10 kilonewton. And you can see this 3 here is left side, right side. And other than that, this 9 kilo is also right side, because this 9 kilo will also affect this member, right side. And after that, this 2 kilonewton is acting inward, right? So this 2 kilonewton, so this is 9. So total effect, you understand? This 10 kilonewton is pulling outwards, so tensile effect. This 3 kilonewton is pulling outwards, so tensile effect. This 9 kilonewton is pulling outward, tensile effect. This 2 kilonewton pulling inside, so compressive effect. And in last class, I told you that whenever you have tensile loading, you take positive, and when you have compressive loading, you take negative, because it decreases the length. Okay, so by using this concept, we can add them algebraically. How will you add them algebraically? You will add like this: 3 is tensile, plus 9 is tensile, minus 2 is compressive. So if you summarize this, you'll be getting 10 kilonewton. Means this side also 10 kilonewton, and here you got positive 10. Positive 10 means final is 10. Means this member will experience tensile loading. So how will you find out change in length for this member? You have to apply play. Okay, in this play concept, your P is applied loading, that is 10 kilonewton here, and this L is the length of this much portion. Whatever portion will be given, suppose L1 is given, L2 is given, L3 is given, then you put L1, and whatever cross section area is given here, that cross section area you put here, and then you put Young's modulus. Always keep in mind, when you talk about stress is equal to Young's modulus into strain, so here your strain has no unit. Why strain has no unit? Because it is the ratio of change in length by original length. So meter and meter will get cancelled, or whatever is the unit, centimeter, millimeter, whatever, they will get cancelled. so strain is unitless. And it means what? Your stress and E, they should have same unit. Stress, yesterday we discussed, stress is nothing but force by area. So this force is nothing but Newton, area is nothing but area means meter square. So Newton per meter square is your stress unit. Newton per meter square is also known as unit of pressure, right? So Pascal, I'm trying to say that stress unit will be Newton meter square, Newton per meter square or Pascal, and same unit will go for E. E is constant, but it has unit. For example, our G value is 9.81 meter per second square. It is a constant, but it has unit. So sometimes constants are having unit, sometimes constants are not having unit. Okay. For example, pi is a constant value, but it is unitless, right? Okay. Sorry. Now we go for section CD. Okay. I will erase this part. And now I will draw section CD. You see how easy it is? You draw section CD. It is very easy. Now, this 10 kilonewton is acting outside, so you apply outside. And this 3 kilonewton is acting inside, you apply inside. So 10 here and 3 here. Now go to the right face. On the right face, 2 kilonewton is inside, 9 is outside. Now you add them and find the answers. So finally 10 and 3 is giving you 7. So this 7 is outside because 10 is dominating. Then here 2 and 9. Now if you check 2 and 9, then how much you'll be getting with this 2 and 9? 7. But that 7 is outside. Okay, so both sides outside. So outside means again tensile. This member experiencing tensile. So if the member experiencing tensile, that's all. You can find out your change in length. Change in length, if you want to find out, L2 you put, again apply formula PL by AE. So here L is original length. So that is length of the CD member. That is L2. So you can put 2L2. And loading is 7. And area, that area is nothing but area of cross section of this particular bar, like here, whatever is cross section. Now, in same way, we can go for DB. So I'm drawing DB here. So on DB, on the left face, you have 2 outside, then you have 3 inside, then you have 10 outside, 2, 3, 10. So you can see 2 and 10 outside and minus 3 inside. So 12, total 10 plus 2, 12 minus 3, 9. So we got finally 9 outward. In same way, you check out on the right face. There is only one force, so 9 kilonewton. That's all done. So again, for this member also, we can find out change in length. Finding change in length is very, very easy. So this is what is we call as free body diagram, because on every individual, we try to understand how many forces are acting, and because of that, length is increasing or decreasing. So see here, in the entire member, any member is not experiencing compressive load. Any member is not experiencing compressive. So all are experiencing tensile. So in everywhere, your del L is increasing. Imagine in any case, if you have any one member inside like compressing. So in that case, your length, the particular change in length will decrease. So that will take as negative. Okay. Now you see. What if we have bars of varying cross section? Suppose you have one bar like this, and you have another bar like this, and again suppose, imagine you have another bar like this, and all the three are, you know, experiencing tensile load of P, and suppose they are made up of different material also. For example, suppose this is copper, this is aluminium, this is something else, suppose this is iron. So, because these materials are different, so their E values, Young's modulus will be different. So you put here E1 Young's modulus, here E2 Young's modulus, here E3 Young's modulus. And you can clearly see we are considering length and area, everything is different. Here L1 length, here L2 length, here L3 length. And I'm also considering area is not same. That is the main topic, bars with varying cross section. So here you consider this area cross section is A1, this area of cross section as A2, this area of cross section as A3. So this entire area of cross section now known, and you have to find out the change in length. So if you want to find out change in length here, so you should know this member. You draw this member and draw FBD. How will you draw FBD? On the left face, how many forces acting? Only one force. On the right face, how many forces acting? Only one force. So P and P. That's all. Solved. So if you want to find out change in length of L1, how will you solve? P play. PL1 by A even. A1. That's all. In same way, if you want to talk about this guy, so draw that, the green color member. Draw this, and you can see in left side, on the left face, only one force is acting, that is P here. And on the right, only one force is acting, that is this thing P here. So again, loading we got P. So we can find out change in length in the second member, L2. Again, apply same concept. PL2 by A2, E2. Then same goes here. If you have this kind of member, then same. On the left face, what is the force acting? This is the force acting. So P. On the right side, what is the force acting? This is the force acting. P. Almost done. You can find out a change in length L3 here. How can you find out? Apply the same formula. Play PL by AE. Put 3, 3, 3, and that's all. Now, all these change in lengths you can add together and you can find out the final change in length. It's like del L total is nothing but del L1 plus del L2 plus del L3. That's all. And keep in mind, maybe they may give the same material. So if material is same, then E1, E2 and E3 will be same. If they are giving same length, then L1, L2, L3 will be same. And if they are giving same cross-section area, in that case, you will be giving only one this kind of bar. Okay, because area of cross-section is same. Now, we can go for bar of tapering section. What is the meaning of bar of tapering section? See, suppose I am taking a bar like this. Now you see, this is tapered bar. So you just consider left side your diameter is D1 and right side your diameter is D2, and we are loading the bar on its longitudinal axis. Suppose this is the axis. So here we are applying the load P and applying the load P. Bar is loaded now. Okay. Once the bar is loaded, then we have to know that what will be the change in length. So actually, if I will give you a simple bar like this and I will give you loading PP, then I'll ask what is the change in length. Then direct apply the formula play PL by AE. And you can find out what is P, the applied load, what is L, the length of the bar, what is A, area of cross section, what is E, Young's modulus of the material. But here our bar is tapered. So if your bar is tapered, then you should remember the direct formula of the tapered bar. That formula is nothing but, you can see here, there is a small trick. With that trick, you can remember the formula easily. Imagine, just imagine, I'm giving you a trick. Just imagine, you know that in the formula of P, in the formula of change in length, you are getting PL by AE. Now, if this length is L and this length is L, then okay, no problem. There is nothing difference in this. Load is P, load is P. Young's modulus is E, Young's modulus is E. But trick is, you see the A. This A, suppose this is circular bar. So what will be the area for the circular bar? Pi d square by 4. Okay. Same concept you apply for this. This d square you split as d1, d2. That's all done. d1, d2. It means you can remember the formula as del L is equal to PL by 4. Sorry, not 4. Pi d1, d2 by 4. 4 will go up into E. Simple. This portion is nothing but the area. I am just saying the trick and you can remember this. So tapering bar, students feel difficult, but actually if you have trick, why to feel difficult, right? Change in length easily you can find out, because remembering play formula is very easy. And after that, you can find out change in length. Right? Dhruv, Gaurav, are you getting what I'm saying? Yeah, this d square only I'm splitting. Yeah, yeah, only d square I'm splitting. Okay. Now see. It is a trick actually. Because the bar is tapered bar, so both side you will not be having same diameter, right? Here you will be having different diameter, here you will be having different diameter. So I am trying to give similarity between this formula and this formula. Okay. Now see. Our another concept is about elongation due to self weight. What is the meaning of this? Suppose like in last class I gave you a little idea that if you have ceiling, from the ceiling, if you are hanging something, imagine it is not breaking. But imagine you are again hanging little extra weight. You are again adding little extra weight. You are keep on adding extra weight. So because of that, there may be chance that this bar may break. Okay, that is one thing. But actually, because of self-weight also, elongation will come into picture. Because of self-weight also elongation, because it is a mass. So because of self-weight also elongation will come. Elongation means nothing but change in length. There is a word called elongation, that is nothing but change in length. So for this, it is very easy. Directly try to understand the trick again. Again, my trick. See guys, what is our change in length formula? Play, right? Okay. This formula is valid for what kind of a situation? If you have any bar, and here also you are applying the load, both side you are applying the load. That's why you are finding out this formula. But in this situation, your P is, I am considering the weight of the bar is P. P is what? P is not the applied load this time, because we are not applying the load this time. This time we are finding out change in length only because of self weight. So I am considering weight is W, so that W I am considering as P. Just to synchronize all the formulas, I am saying weight you consider as P. Because weight is also Newton, P is also Newton, weight is also force, load is also force. Okay. So idea is, trick. What is your trick? Your one side ceiling is fixed. So now only one side P is available. It means do half, that's all. So change in length is very easy, PL by 2AE, done. Okay, now if you have tapering cross section means, yes. Actually proof I am not giving, I am only giving the trick, how to remember the formula directly. See, the trick is, if you have any bar and both side if you have load P and P, then what is the formula? Del L is equal to PL by AE. But imagine you just consider the case like this. One side ceiling and this P is not the applied load. You imagine the P is the weight of the bar. Your W is equal to P. So in that case only one side you are having, right? So this P is nothing but P by 2. So remember the trick. Earlier you were having double P, now you are having only half P one side. Clear? It is just a trick. Okay. Because with the trick you can remember lot of formulas. Now see how I am remembering all the formulas. In same way you can remember all the formulas. And they all are my trick. So now see. Now another bar of tapering cross section. See, earlier just now we saw that, okay, if you have a bar, then your cross section is same. So because of self weight, how much elongation is there? PL by 2AE. But if your same hanging bar is this kind of triangle, so we say taper. So in that case, here how much diameter is available? So you are going to write formula, and what is the weight here? W. That W you can consider again as P. So just find out change in length. Beautiful formula. Same PL by 2AE is going to be the formula. PL by 2AE. Even though it is tapering, does not matter. We are getting the same formula. So now, what are the things we understood? If you have applied loading, then how will you change the formula? If you have tapered bar, then how will you change the formula? Then because of self weight, how will you change the formula? Then if taper bar is hanging, then how will you change the formula? Then you go for composite section. What is the meaning of composite section? In composite section, you have multiple type of bars. Suppose, imagine this is a hollow tube. In this hollow tube, here I have hollow portion.